na fa wo ho pa ma je
Thank the Lord. Beautiful, beautiful music. Amen. Are you blessed?
Yes.
We thank God. 3 weeks ago, that was January 4th, the Lord presented his propositions to you about this year.
What you mean, sir? Sir, and now, when you are
and God declared to you that this is a year of his abundance of blessings to you. And
after
that, it was like God's favor is for you this year. In order for that to become a reality, today I want to declare to you how the year of God's favor can be real in your life. Exalt Christ this year 2020. Shall we pray? Father, the hour has come that your people are waiting to hear the voice of God. Please, Lord, speak through me, your servant, that I may speak. And let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to your sight, O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Let the whole church say,
Amen.
Exalt Christ this year, 2020. In order for you to receive the abundance of God's blessings, you need to exalt Christ in your life.
Number one,
let the love of Christ unite you.
Ma Jesus Christo ne dono enkamum.
Unite you and your wife.
Enkawune woyiri embom.
Unite you and your children.
Enkawune woma embom.
Unite you and the church.
Enkawune asafunumbom.
The church, when it's united, receives abundance of God's blessings.
Se asafunu ekabomwa enya onyankopon shida bebrebe.
When a family unites,
they
receive abundance of blessings.
Wansaka inshira bebrebe.
God's spirit cannot operate in disunity.
Onyankopon ehonhom entumi nye adwuma awo bebia basabasa.
And that's why Paul wrote to the Colossians.
Enunti na onyankopon chirokoma Colossians.
And told them in Colossians chapter 3 verse 12 and 14.
Therefore,
As God's chosen people, holy and dearly beloved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgives you. And all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. I want you to listen carefully.
Paul says,
clothe yourself with compassion. Let us be compassionate to one another. Let us feel for each other. Because the church is one body. Right now, as I speak to you, I have pain in my toes. And when I put on my shoe, it took me 30 minutes to put on shoe. My whole body was struggling hard to put the shoe on. The pain was unbearable. The whole body was having pain because of the toe. You see, you are part of the body. So when there's pain in you, it should reflect in the whole body. When there's joy in you, it should reflect in the whole body. And so you could be the toe. Your pain affects the whole body. It could be your stomach. You could be the stomach. Your pain affects the whole body. Have you ever touched rose flower?
Friend rose,
and when you want to take the rose, your finger was pricked by the rose plant.
Na rose nhwire no so any bi ewo won sa.
How see how the whole body over your body.
Yeah, she said any pedu any nyina ebre ho.
This little pin when it touch you.
Sa de akitu e se ewo wa.
You feel it from your head?
Just if you tiso.
From your body?
Woni pedu e.
To the toe.
E de ko si won ase.
The body is one.
Ni pedu an ya baako.
So we
as a church,
in order for us to receive the blessings of God, we need to be one body. I said we need to have compassionate, kindness, humility. See, as I'm feeling the toe, if I'm not preaching to you now, and I move my shoe, my hand will be touching and making a little bit, touching the toe, smoothing it a little bit. You see, the whole body is affected. My hands are affected. My brains are affected. This is how we need to feel for each other. We need to forgive ourselves. The grievances, I beg you, whatever was the grievance last year, don't bring it to 2020.
Jesus, what time we come here now? Ewo, yemu biara munte mono, enfengura, enfimpim yenuedu nimu.
Don't blow away your blessings.
Baby, Emma Winshira no enshiro.
By carrying over your grievances.
Bra, what day we yao anansi obi muti na waka adiura afiwe mu.
Forgive as the Lord forgives you.
Fache sadi urade adi chawo no.
And the Paul says, and over all these virtues, put on love.
Sir Paul says, wasani yamenyina muno yamfa odo atadi enshi.
Let love be demonstrated among ourselves. And this will now culminate in a perfect unity for the church. Number two, let the peace of Christ control you.
Ma Jesus Christo asumujie no eni wo so hene.
Colossians chapter 3 verse 15 says.
Colossians 4 eti miansan chichemu edunu mu say.
Let the peace of Christ rule in your heart.
Na Christo Yesu asumujie eni peni
wakumem. Since as members of one body.
Say yaye eni pedua bakono.
You were called to peace.
Your friend say your friend ba asumujie mu.
And be thankful.
Say
you
have
been called to peace. There shouldn't be war among us. All these little things, let it go. And be at peace. My brother, my sister. Be at peace with yourself. Do know that some of us don't forgive ourselves. Yes. You have not forgiven yourself. You are still brooding of what you failed to do. You hate your own self. You wish to be somebody else. Please love yourself. So you can love somebody. Because if you don't love yourself, you cannot love anybody. So love yourself and who you are. Love the way Christ has brought you up. Be content with yourself. And thank God for who you are. So that you can appreciate what is in your brother and what is your sister. Paul said, let peace rule over your heart.
Paul said,
since as one body we were called to peace.
Say,
I'm called to peace. Tell your turn to your brother, tell your sister and say, I am at peace with you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Be at peace with one another. It is only when we are at peace with ourselves. And then we can now receive the blessings of God. And Paul says, and be thankful.
And Paul says,
don't be ungrateful. Thank God for where God has brought you. Thank God for health. I am talking about my toes that I'm limping, but there are some people who even can't walk. So if I can walk, I thank God. You are not thanking God, but you can eat. You can talk viaga.
Who to me kasa?
Thank God for who you are. And what God has done for you. Always be thankful. Listen to this. In John chapter 14.
Johanni etidu 9.
Verse 27. Jesus said,
Jesus say,
peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I don't give you as the world gives you. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And do not be afraid. Christ says, I'm giving you peace. His peace passes all understanding. So we have peace. Say, I have peace with Christ. Christ has given you peace. Be content with that. Hey, if you are going to a war-torn country, you appreciate peace. I've been to a war-torn country. Soon after the war in Rwanda, I went there as a division personnel. I went there and I saw the devastation of war. I saw how 9-year-old girls have become mothers to their little 6-year-old 2-year-old children because their mothers have been killed.
Me hu said ya nkwala maiwan ketenkete ababa ya mame ama wonu ankuma sense o mame wawu.
Because when you enter a home, the adults have been killed. Living little children. 8-year-olds, 9-year-olds, 10-year-olds have become the mothers. Taking care of the little ones. That war has finished with them.
It's just a
Jesus says, I give you my peace.
Jesus said,
I saw
me
12-year-old boys,
11-year-old
boys, holding AK rifles. Yes. And I asked them, what are you doing with this? They said, it's for my security, they said. Because if I hold this, nobody can kill me. So I am holding the gun to protect myself. I said, why don't you go to school?
No.
If I go to school, they will kill me.
Because
but if I hold this gun, I can protect myself. That is what can do to young people.
Jesus says,
I give you my peace, which passes all understanding. Let's pray that the peace we can enjoy. And Christ said, I've given it to you. 2020. Christ said, I've given you my peace. His peace is upon you. His peace is in your home. His peace in the church. His peace will be with you at work. Be at peace with yourself, my brother. Be at peace with yourself, my sister. So you can be at peace with others. And Christ says, let not your hearts be troubled. And be not afraid. Because I've given you my peace. No matter what the devil would do, let not your heart be troubled. Because
if you say,
you should not be afraid. Because I have won against the devil. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 3. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace.
Just say, "Yedi obe tumi biara se obe mahongo mungaboma ode amano atina mumu."
I want to beg you, choir.
Mpesa misremo choir.
I want to beg you, singing groups in this church.
Mpesa misremo nyimtuku ahudo.
And all the church members. Let us make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace.
Mumma yenye di obe tumi biara se obe mahongo mnoa yankufan kaboma ode amaya no yensa kasa sunjiano.
If we practice this,
sir, yeah.
All this kika and wara will not be in this church.
Just say, but if you are coming away, you will not be a
if you are at peace with yourself, and you go to the fellowship hall,
now call baby,
and the food doesn't taste good.
Now, if you are no and yet the papa,
you ask who cook it.
There be who is just a one and
none of your business.
No, you ask him.
Be at peace.
Just say, Yasumje.
Don't ask who cook your neck. If I were the one, I would do it this way.
That's
none of your business. Be at peace with yourself. What they offer you, thank God. If you can't eat it, take it back and stop talking. Be at peace. Let this church be at peace. So we can have the blessings of God upon us. Philippians chapter 4, verse
7.
The peace of God, which transcends all understanding, is what Christ wants to give us. So please receive it in Jesus' name. Colossians chapter 3, verse 16. He says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. As you teach and admonish one another with this wisdom. As you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. Please, when we come to church, Let us admonish one another with wisdom. Not criticizing. Not destroy one another. Not looking at somebody with a different eye. Not when somebody passes there, you spit.
No.
That is the bush method. C'est la situation des villageois.
Aha, non, non, ça fait qu'on est au French, mon. C'est la situation des villageois.
Ben oui,
Nancy,
the people of God. So we have to dwell in the word of God. And admonish ourselves in the wisdom of the word of God. Not condemning, but building up. Young person, I want to build you up. I don't want to put you down. You are all my grandchildren. You don't know that? You know that, right? I want to be proud of you. Are you hearing me? I want to be proud of you. So that when you become a medical doctor, or you become a
physicist,
or you become an astronaut, and you go to the moon, and they mention your name, I will stand somewhere, and I put at my hand, at my chest, that is my grandson, my granddaughter. I want to be proud of you. So I want to build you up. Let's build our young people. Let's build our women. Let's build our men. Don't put anybody down. No. Nobody is superior in this church. The only superior person in this church is Jesus Christ.
Is
he we look up to. So don't let us look down on anybody. If you think I've said something that is not good, don't rebuke me in public. Come to me. Punch me in my stomach at my office and I'll be quiet.
Jesus, me kambri bi na uhwe unse makasa etia wa. E bedwam no memu manim tia na nse nkasa ntia me. Udi ebra me office, uba kura na opa, fa kuturuku sibie funu zo, mekama no atum me nkuntu pa.
Yes, that's how to admonish.
Uh-huh.
But not to destroy.
Yes, 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 yes.
And to dim the light of somebody.
Na ye dum afoforo ehan.
And to discourage. We need to encourage. We have to be encouragers. Because we want to receive the blessings of God. So
it says,
sing the songs of hymns. And spiritual songs. With gratitude in your heart.
But
don't sing only on a Sabbath day. And then on Sunday. There you sing the song of Shatawale.
Now to Shatawale there.
No.
Dabi.
You sing the song of the hymns and the spiritual songs every day in your life.
Yes, unhumu nyomo no tono de biara da o abrabum.
Number four.
The toso enaino.
Let the name of Christ lead you.
My Jesus Christ dino and you kind.
Remember the hymn that says, take the name of Christ with you. Child of sorrow and of woe. It will joy and comfort give you. Take it wherever you go. Precious name, how has he? Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, how has he? Hope of earth and joy of heaven. Colossians chapter 3 verse 17 says,
Colossians 4:18 and 17.
And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of Jesus Christ. Giving thanks to God.
The Father through this. Hallelujah.
So let's do everything through Christ. In word and in deed. Even when you want to give gift, give it in the name of Christ. When you are eating, do so in the name of Jesus Christ. In every way, give thanks to the Lord. Let the name of Christ lead you. At your school, let the name of Christ lead you. Let your schoolmate name know that you are a person of Christ. Take the name of Christ with you.
For Jesus Christ
at your workplake.
Oh, you mean,
take the name of Christ with
for
you.
For Jesus Christ enante.
In your marriage.
Oh, what
you mean, take the name of Christ with you.
For Jesus Christ enante.
You see, if you take the name of Christ.
Sir, would Jesus Christ enante?
You as a wife.
Wo, sir, oyere.
You cannot stay with your husband.
Wouldn't to me and kancha ukunu.
And you begin to build a house in Ghana, and your husband has no idea.
Wouldn't to me no ukunu trabra who see fear Ghana ukunu nim.
Have you taken the name of Christ?
Wouldn't you Jesus Christ Odin Anante?
I want to hear from you.
Would you Jesus Christ Odin Anante?
Have you taken the name of Christ? Or you as a man. You cannot stay with your wife here.
Wouldn't you mean who could you didn't know?
And you tell your wife, oh, you are going to Ghana.
Okay, you say we go Ghana.
And when you go to Ghana,
as you go to Ghana,
you open a woman embassy there.
No, I can't be a man embassy.
So you have a wife in Ghana, you have a wife here.
Who are you in Ghana? Who are you in
Ghana? Have you taken the name of Christ?
Would you yes
you
did?
Am I hearing you?
Meet him in Ghana.
Am I hearing you? Take the name of Christ with you.
For Jesus Christ Odinante.
Let your hands be clean. In the name of Christ.
For Jesus Christ
Odinante. So you can receive the year of God's favor upon you. And the abundance of God's blessings will be upon you. Let the name of Christ lead you. Even when you are singing, let the name of Christ lead you. In your finances, let the name of Christ lead you. In your paying of tithe and offering, let the name of Christ lead you. In everything you do, let the name of Christ lead you. My friends, Christ's name is our identification. This year, let the name of Christ be your identification. Never forget that you belong to Christ. That you are not your own. That your body, soul, and spirit belong to Jesus Christ. You are a child of King Jesus. So Christ is your identification. These are our little children.
Yeah,
when you talk to them,
so
they will tell you. If you tell them, are you Ghanaians? No, we are not Ghanaians. Our parents are from Ghana.
We are America.
So the American identification is they are so proud about that.
Americans are Zudian woman.
I want you to be proud that you are a child of King Jesus. Not a child of America. Christ is your identification.
Jesus Christ.
Where do you come from? If you are not from Ghana,
so
if you Ghana, you are not from America.
If you America,
you are from Christ.
If you Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hey.
You are a member of the family of God. So Christ's name is your identification. Christ's name is our authority. Speak in the name of Christ. That is your authority. I have no authority. As I stand here, Christ's name is that what I stand on as a pastor. If Christ is not there,
so yes,
I am not there. I stand upon Christ. On Christ, the solid rock are standing.
Oh, yes, Christo, obutan no so
enemigina. Other grounds are sinking sand.
As asia kenina
and your town. So I can tell you, my hope is built on nothing.
Me leader soon see she so say yes.
My power is built on nothing.
To me and see she so.
My walking is built on nothing. My preaching is built on nothing.
Me some pack make can see bibia so.
On the solid rock Christ Jesus. That is my authority. I derive my authority from Christ. And so you derive your authority from Jesus Christ. Because with Christ, you are more than a conqueror. With Christ, victory is yours. With Christ, the year of favor is yours. With Christ, God's abundance of blessing is for you. 2020 is our year. So let the name of Christ lead you. Study his word. And know him intimately. And let Christ lead you. And let Christ be your authority. And you are leader. And he will guide you. It is the name of Christ that should lead us. Oh, this year, don't lead by yourself. This year, don't look up at anybody. Don't look at yourself. Because if you look at yourself, you will fail. Don't look at somebody. You will fail. Don't look at America. You will fail. Don't look at Ghana. Don't look at Togo. Don't look at Cote d'Ivoire. Don't look at Liberia. You will fail. But this year, let the name of Christ lead you. And you are not going to fail. And you will receive the abundance of God's blessings. That is yours for the taking. Oh, my hope for you is that. That is my will. Have joy. If you as a church member, you allow Christ to lead you and you can receive the abundance of blessings. But when you are blessed, I am blessed. Hallelujah. If you are blessed, I am blessed. Turn to your neighbor and say, if you are blessed, I am blessed. Yes.
Amen.
My hands are blessed. My hands are blessed. Yes. Today is your day to make sure that this year the name of Christ will lead you. You make the year 2020 as a year Christ is going to lead you in all your ways. And I can guarantee you, the promises of God will be fulfilled in you. He will never fail you. Do you believe this? Do you believe this? Then stand up with me. All to Jesus I surrender. God and our Father, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
For the provisions you have made for us.
Mm.
And the way you are laying before us to receive your blessings.
Mm.
Please help us.
Hallelujah.
That we will allow Jesus to lead us.
Amen.
And that your promises in us,
yes, Lord,
will be fulfilled.
Amen.
Give us the courage.
Mm.
Give us the strength.
Yes, Lord.
to let Christ lead us.
Amen.
Let Christ be our authority.
Amen.
And let Christ be our guidance.
Amen.
Let this year,
yes, Lord,
truly be a year of your abundance upon us.
Amen.
So we thank you.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Mama,
I have one little assignment I need to do before I sit down. I should have done it. But they say if you sang kofa is not a bad thing. So all those deacons and deaconesses who have been voted for 2020-2021 who are not ordained deacons and deaconesses, please come forward.
Asafo asomfo aya pa won afiwe mu ani afie di ho no ya yemfa yensengu wo mo so no momra monim.
Properly. And I want all the ordained elders to join me here.
Asafo mpenimfo a yɛde yɛn sɛ gu ɔmoso no nyinaa nso so ɛmɛka me ho.
One more, where is it? That one more. Shira me se usha Jacob fa un satu me su. We are praying that you as deacons and deaconesses, that God himself will place his hand upon you just as he did on Jacob. Hallelujah. So today is your day to receive the full authority of your office, the function you have been called to do.
If you young coupon, a war, Jumidia, your friend will say, Mumbayono.
And so I want you to kneel down.
And until Messrem say, Munkum could to Jenny.
Elders, I want you to line up. Don't be grouped, just line up.
Like that.
Line up the way the Muncha people have lined up.
Muncha, Munchia said, ye. Munyan, you know, Munim said, ye, Omono, a cotoko to one of Pepe.
Around them, yes.
Chong Munchia, continue.
Yes. Get down there. Yes. And raise your hands up.
Na montena monsa o moso.
Almighty Father in heaven, we come before you. Thank you for these men and women, young men and young women who are here ready to be dedicated by you in the service of Christ.
Yes, Lord.
Even as they have knelt down before you and the elders have stretched their hands upon them, let the hand of Christ touch them.
Hallelujah.
And ordain them.
Amen.
But you are the only one who can ordain.
Oh, yes.
So send forth your spirit.
Yes, Lord.
And ordain each one of them.
Amen.
Both men and women.
Yes, Lord.
Ordain them.
Amen.
For the service of Christ.
Yes, Lord.
And Father, as your hand reach out and touch them. I pray that they will feel the empowerment of Christ.
Hallelujah.
To serve him with joy and gladness.
Amen.
Remove sin from them.
Amen.
And give them a clear mind to serve you.
Hallelujah.
And help them that every day they will grow in grace.
Amen.
They will grow to serve you.
Amen.
And they will grow to love you.
Amen.
So, Father, we have raised our hands on them.
Yes, Lord.
Let these hands be the hand of Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ.
Hallelujah.
Touching each one of them.
Amen.
And now unto you.
Yes, Lord.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you.
Amen.
May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Oh, yes.
Peace as you serve.
Amen.
Peace in your heart.
Amen.
Peace with yourself.
Amen.
And peace with what you need to do for Christ.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Congratulations.
Elders,
shake their hands.
Some people for no munchia on sim. Omafa ejumekunini.
I will ask all the ordained elders.
It's Abri Metun Safre, a sorry penny for Yadi and Segu Musunina.
As soon as we finish from here,
say Yanya free happy.
Meet me outside
there. Mushia me wo abontene
at our new church bus.
Asafuno bus fufrono.
We will go and dedicate that bus.
Yebeko ako tu ashe urade ensa.
So that the bus can begin to function.
Sebe ya yebetuya se edi bus no.
We didn't buy there to park.
Yankotose yedibisi ho.
We bought it to use.
Yakoto yese yedibedi juma.
To the glory of the Lord.
Ashe urade enmunyam.
So today we dedicate it.
Enuntine yebetu ashe urade ensa.
And we have our brother here. Rahu is here.
Rahu
is our chief driver.
Wono ena waye ye bus no
driver pini. We dedicate the bus.
Say ye tushi radin sa.
Rahu to move the bus around the compound.
Ye pese ye nua Rahu betu bus no na.
To the glory of God.
Wadi wakakakra ashe radin mnyam.
This is for us.
Ye 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 dia.
And we will use it to the glory of God.
Na ye debe ye juma ashe radin en mnyam.
Hallelujah. I hope and believe that you are blessed today. Amen. Before we sing our final hymn, I would like to let you be aware of these important announcements. As we already know, our shepherdess, Mrs. Teresa Bwachedankwa, has lost the brother. And the funeral is coming off this weekend. Elder Alfred is saying that all those of us who are interested in going to help
Elder Albert Mensah say obi biara wo pese wo ko sey ni bi no
to help our mother to meet him right after the service in the church house.
Okota
again, the church at Revival continues today. Right after we have taken our meals. At this moment, we shall all rise up and take our hymn. And open to 474. Take the name of Jesus with you.
Take the name of Jesus with you. Take the name of Jesus with you.
And the guidance and the leadership you are giving us. We praise your name for the love whereby you have loved us. Shall we say the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you.
Abba.